So now we're going to start actually doing the matrix multiplication. And so we're going to show the first three steps of this. The first thing we're going to do is take the value vector and the row pointer vector, and together we're going to create a segmented representation of the value vector. Note that each segment in this resulting vector represents one row of the sparse matrix, and the row pointer shows where each segment head begins. The next thing that we're going to do is gather these vector values using these column indices to create a corresponding list from which we can multiply each of these individual matrix entries. So, we see that value A is located in column 0, which means it needs to be multiplied by the vector element in row 0. So what we're going to do is use these column indices to gather from this vector, and that's going to give us the following array. Okay, now we actually need to do the pairwise multiplications, so we simply use a map operation to multiply this vector, not caring about the segmentation, by this vector here, and it's going to give us yet another vector of the same size. And the final step is that we need to add up the partial products within each segment to be able to get the final output vector. And that's where we can use segmented scan. But now we have to add up the partial products on each row to get the output vector. Specifically, we need to add the partial products within each segment. And that's where our segmented scan comes in. We need to do an exclusive segmented sum scan to sum up each segment of partial products. It's actually a little bit more convenient to do a backwards exclusive segmented sum scan. So while the sums instead end up at the head of each segment, since then the row pointer array can be used to gather those per row sums into a dense vector. Now, here we're actually using a segmented scan to perform what's really a segmented reduce. And if you want a good challenge, think about how you might want to build a segmented reduce that's a little bit more efficient than a segmented scan. Just to go back to our original matrix, to make sure we're actually going to get the same answers. So here's our original matrix here and our original vector. And we note that we dot product this vector with this vector to get this answer. This vector dotted with this vector to get this answer. And then this vector dotted with this vector to get this answer. And you'll see if you look at each one of these rows, they're going to correspond to the sums within each one of these segments. But the nice part about multiplying using this sparse matrix representation is that we're never multiplying by any zeros at all. So here we've actually had to multiply by zeros, and then we just throw away the answers because they're going to be zero. On the other hand, when we're actually implementing this using a true sparse matrix representation, we're not going to have any zeros present at all. So this is going to be substantially more efficient for any real matrix that has a significant amount of zeros.